Hello, Neil. Thank you very much for joining us here at the Warhammer Preview Online Black Library Show. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you. Good to talk to you.
I know that you've generated artwork for Warhammer 40,000 and Warhammer Age of Sigmar, but I think a lot of Warhammer fans will know you best for your iconic work on the Horus Heresy and Siege of Terra cover series. Is that fair to say?
Yes, I'm glad you said it, not me. It's better coming from somebody else. But yes, we've been working on the Horus Heresy now for quite a long time. I think it's over 15 years from the beginning.
Did you ever think it would last this long when you first did the Horus Rising cover?
If I had have known, things might have been very different. No, not at all. I think, as far as I remember, it was just one of my first few jobs I ever did for Black Library. And it was just a brief that was sent to me by, I think it was Christian Dunn at the time. And he thought I'd be a good fit for the subject because I knew it quite well, being a fan, and also the kind of work I did. It just seemed like an easy fit.
You've been very kind to share some of your work in progress pictures with us, so we can talk a little bit about your creative process.
It always starts off with a brief, which is sent to me by my editor at Black Library. So it starts off with words. Usually the first picture I ever draw when in the process is just a very simple black and white picture where I try and get everything on the page that's required in the briefs. I basically just throw it all down on the page, knowing that I might get it wrong. But then you send it off to the editors who, you know, send it around the team. And the process goes that they come back with some feedback, some changes, or can we maybe move the angle to here, or show a bit more of this person or this part of the world, if it's important to the story. And then you just kind of massage the picture around until you get a thumbnail. In terms of the, are we allowed to say what the piece we're talking about?
We're talking about Saturnine, yeah.
Saturnine, yes, of course, yeah. So, yeah, I think the first pieces I remember of that was just a quite abstract drawing of the Primarchs like jumping onto a ledge. And it was just a very simple black and white drawing that I think the angle was quite extreme. Feedback came back to me that they wanted something a bit more kind of descriptive of the environment that the story was taking place. So I kind of moved the camera around, added a bit of colour. The whole scene was quite pulled back, but I think each time the feedback was, can we just go in a bit tighter? Because you always want to show the main characters as much as possible, because that's what the story's about.
It looks like there was definitely a clear idea to have Angron landing like a thunderbolt in the middle of the defences, and then just the first pencil sketch really strongly communicates that, and then as the iterations have moved on, you've started to add in, this is where the space for the spine needs to go, this is the space for the cover, but the sentiment was definitely captured in that first pencil sketch, and then it's a case of refining it to make it fit.
Exactly. I mean, a lot of the time I do sketch with those rough compositional ideas, elements, sorry, in mind. You know, I know that there will be a title box here, the spine will go here, and there will be blurb on the back of the, you know, a barcode sort of area. So I'm aware that there's those elements there. So that's always, I'm always like pulling on those elements when I'm sort of designing, laying it out. But yeah, oftentimes that kind of initial, I usually call it an exploration because I'm literally exploring the idea. Sometimes I just do one piece, like with Saturnine, but with other covers, I think the very first cover, because I wasn't quite sure of what we were doing or what the tone was, I think I did about 4 or 5, which is overkill, but you know, for what it was at the time, it was a necessary step just to really get a direction. So yeah, it depends on the book cover.
You can see the placement of color. That's something that goes down early on, I guess. If you're creating a cover, you want to create something eye-catching and attractive that might sing to you from across the shop, across the store. And then you get a bit closer and you see all of those details worked into it. So do you start with those sort of broad themes of colour and then sharpen it up as you go along as well?
Yes. I mean, a lot of the time, it comes down to that old adage of, you know, value does all the work, but colour gets all the credit. So I'm usually working in black and white, so you can get the high points and the dark points, white points and dark points. So that's the thing that I think, from what I've read, my, you know, colour theory analysis, you know, studies over the years, that's what's stood out for me. So it's all about those broad strokes of the lights and darks.
I understand that you've got a bit of a sneak peek to share with us.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'd like to show you a piece of art I've recently worked on. And I mean, I can't give you any details about it, but I thought you might like to see what's on the horizon.
Well, thank you very much. We'd better wrap this up, Neil, before the Inquisition or the Assassinorum send their agents after us. Thank you so much for taking the time to share a little bit about your creative process with us today.
Thank you.
See you soon.